So hi students, so this is the numerical methods and probability theory. Today we are going to start our first unit, that is unit 1, that is solutions of algebraic and transcendental equations. So today we are going to start this first unit. So this unit consists of six models, that is six models or six methods, that is one is bisection method, second one is iteration method, third one is regular policy method, fourth one is Newton-Raphson method, fifth one is Gauss-Jordan method, and sixth one is Gauss-Seidel method. So out of these four models are very, very important. Out of these four models, he will give two models in first question, and last two models he will give for second question. So these are very, very important. So first question consists of four out of four he will give two, and the last two, 5, 6, he will give two. So these six are very, very important. So before going to see these models or methods, we are going to see some of the introduction about that. So first, determination of roots of an equation. So it is in the form f of x equal to 0. So this roots, it has a great importance in fields of science. Not only in science, but it is having the science and engineering, it is having more importance in science and engineering. So in this chapter, we considered some simple methods. So these are some simple methods to find the roots of the equation. So next we are going to see some definitions. So for this definition, we will give for 2 marks. So number one is polynomial. We already know what is the definition of a polynomial. So polynomial means an expression of the form f of x equal to a naught x power n plus a1 x power n minus 1 plus a2 x power n minus 2 plus and so on plus a. So this is called as a polynomial. So this is a polynomial in x of degrees n. So here a0, a1, a2, so on, an, they may be a real numbers or they may be a complex numbers. So this is called as a polynomial in x of degree n. So this is the definition you will give for 2 marks. It is also very, very important. So next we are going to see next definition, that is algebraic equation. So what is the definition of an algebraic equation? So a polynomial in x of degree n. So when this polynomial is equated to 0, that means f of x equal to 0. Then it is called as an algebraic equation. So we can take any example. So here I have taken an example, x square plus 2x plus 1 equal to 0. So this is an example. So this is an algebraic equation. So we can say that f of x is an algebraic function, then the equation f of x equal to 0 is called as algebraic equation. So if f of x is a transcendental function, then it is called as a transcendental equation. So next we are going to see the next definition, that is transcendental equation. So transcendental equation means if a polynomial contains, that means if this polynomial contains any trigonometric functions or logarithmic functions or exponential functions or any other functions, then it is called as a transcendental equation. That means the transcendental equation must and should contain any of these. That means it can contain trigonometric functions, that is sine, cos, tan, etc., and logarithmic function, that is log of x, log of e power x, and exponential function. Exponential means we already know that e power x. So if a polynomial equation contains these trigonometric functions, logarithmic functions, or exponential functions and any other, then it is called as a transcendental equation. So I have taken 3 examples, that is if f of x equal to x minus x cos x equal to 0. So this equation contains a trigonometric function. So this is a transcendental equation. So in the second example, I have taken log x base 10. So this is the second example. So this equation contains log, that is, it is an example of a transcendental equation. So and the third one contains exponential e power 2x, that is 4 sine x minus e power 2x. So these are the 3 best examples of transcendental equation. That means these equations contains trigonometric functions, logarithmic functions, as well as exponential functions. So we can easily say that these are the best examples of the transcendental equations. So next we are having some properties on the polynomial equation. So number one, first property is fundamental theorem of algebra. So what is the fundamental theorem of algebra? So it is nothing but every polynomial, whatever the polynomial we take, it is of degree n, and exactly it must contain n roots, and that roots may be either real or complex. So this is the fundamental theorem of algebra. That means if you take any polynomial, any polynomial if you take, it must have a degree n, and exactly it must have n roots, that roots may be real or complex. This is the fundamental theorem of algebra. So we are going to use this in solving the problems based on root of the equation. So the second one is intermediate value theory. So this is also very, very important definition. So yeah, this definition is, it's a theorem is, if f of x is continuous on closed interval a, so f of x must be continuous on closed interval a, and f of a and f of b have opposite signs, that means f of a and f of b both must have opposite signs, then root lies between x equal to a and x equal to b. So then the root must and should lies between x equal to a and x equal to b. So this is the intermediate value theorem. So this means that if first of all the condition is f of x must and should be a continuous on closed interval a b, and f of a and f of b must and should have opposite signs. Opposite signs in the sense, it must, one must be a negative one and another one must be a positive one, or one must be a positive one and next one may be a negative one. Then root lies between x equal to a and x equal to b. So this is an example here. I have given an example here. So the example is, if f of x equal x cube minus 2x minus 5 equal to 0. So now what I have to do is, I have to see that whether it root lies between x equal to a and x equal to b. That means I have to take the values. So I can take whatever the values I want, I can take. That means real or complex, whatever the values. That means I can take a positive values, or that means I can take negative values. So here I have taken the positive values. So you will ask in exam to take the negative values, then we have to take the negative values. So if we not ask anything, then we can simply take the positive values. Positive values means it is very easy to do the problem. So we consider about the positive values. So I have taken the values here. So first of all, I have taken f of 0. That means I got minus 5, which is less than 0. So I have taken f of 1, that is minus 6. I have substituted the f of 1 value instead of x. Then I got minus 6, that is also less than 0. So f of 0 is less than 0. F of 1 is less than 0. So I should not take this both. So I have to take another value. So I have taken the x equal to 2. So this also less than 0. So these three are having the same sign, that is less than. So it is not, we already know that in intermediate value theorem, it should have opposite signs, but these three are having the same sign. So I have to take another one. So I have taken x equal to 3. So now I am having 16. So this is greater than 0. So first 3 I have having less than 0, and last f of 3 greater than 0. So I can say that f of a is less than 0 and f of b is greater than 0. So simply I can say that the root lies between f of a and f of b. That means in place of a I am having 2 and in place of b I am having 3. So the root lies between 2 and 3. So this is the intermediate value theorem. So in this part, in this video, we are going to see the 5 definitions. So number 1 is, what is the definition of a polynomial, and what is the definition of an algebraic equation, and what are the transcendental equations, and next one is what is the fundamental theorem of algebra, and what is the intermediate value theorem. So these are the 5 very, very important definitions in 2 marks. You will give for 2 marks. So these are the very, very important definitions. So in the next class, in the next video, we are going to see the 4 models. So 4 models or 4 methods. So this is the video about the 5 definitions on first. So thank you, Amma. Thank you very much. Thanks, student.